Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton and you have found a YouTube channel that loves WordPress. And every Wednesday I'm creating a video just like this to help you improve your WordPress website. So be sure to click subscribe. And of course, I have to give a shout out to Pressable who allows this channel to happen every single month by sponsoring us. You guys, if you need help with your WordPress website, you need support, you need great hosting, be sure to check them out and tell them I sent you. They're an awesome team. They've got awards for their awesome support. All right, so you're here to find a search solution on your website, something that can capture the search queries when a visitor comes to your website and does a quick search. How do you keep track of that? It's really intelligent that you want to keep track of that, right? So let's say, for instance, I come here to search the library of videos and I'm looking for SEO. And I click SEO and I go in here and great, there's a bunch of resources. So that's awesome. So I could have tracked that click or that search rather by Google Analytics to let me know how many times this page was viewed, right? But what if they're doing a search for content that I don't have, which is just as important, if not even more important? So what if they're doing a search for tacos or something really random like that and this type of page comes up, but we wanna be writing to people interested in tacos or whatever it might be, right? We want to figure out what are they searching for once they land on our website. What are they searching for internally? So I use this over on askkori.com as well. I've got it here on the tutorials landing page where you can come here and do a search. I've even got it up here in the top where you can come here and do a search. I want to start capturing what people are asking for and trying to find on my website. So here's the solution for you, y'all. You ready? I found it and it's in the budget of free. We love that. This is a plugin called Search Meter. I'm gonna show you how to install it, super easy setup, and I'm gonna show you what the back end looks like because for the budget of free, this thing's robust. It's really exciting. As of today, of course, so in the future, if you're looking at this video and watching it, please be sure to that it's up to date, that it's going to be good for your specific WordPress version, and we'll get to that right now. So you're gonna go look for Search Meter. Let's go into your dashboard. We're gonna go to plugins, and we're gonna say add new. And we're going to come over here to the little search area and we're just going to do search meter, right? And we should find it right here. This is it. You want to look at this, 30,000 active installs as of today. I mean, that's huge. That's a great following already using this, proving that it's a great plugin, great reviews. And I'll be adding mine here in a minute too. You're going to click install now and activate. If you haven't already, you should have done a backup on your website, right? You always want to be sure that's best practices. To have a backup running on your WordPress website. I'll put more information about that in the description box below. Just click show more and it'll show you kind of how to do that if you haven't already set that up. All right, y'all, so it's activated. That's it. It's there. It's in our space now. So where it lives is inside of settings and search meter. So you wanna go here first and kind of set up parameters around it. Because it's asking you, do you want to show statistics to different users or administrators inside of your website? So I'm going to say only show admins the search results. And there's all sorts of other things that you can say here as well. Hide the do you find this plugin useful section. You know, whatever you want to kind of walk through these individual settings and click save changes. So now it's active, ready to go. It's going to start gathering content. So I've got this search bar up here at the top, right? You click on my little search icon and let's do a search for, I'm going to click refresh though for a second and just be certain that it catches up that I have that plugin there. I'm going to do a search for, let's do SEO, what we just did. I'll do a search and now we've got all of these projects pulling up, all these blog articles pulling up, all this content and classes that I have. And then we're gonna come back into the dashboard. Watch this, this is the cool part. And you get to see where they keep the library of queries. You now have an area over here under dashboard that says search meter. You open that up and here it is. You can see I've already been doing some testing. So the term SEO has been searched twice. It resulted in 68 different results on my website being presented to that person searching. And then there's another one. Here's Google that I did a search for earlier, just testing. Somebody, I did a search for WordPress Wednesday. There you go. And you've got 173 results. Obviously, that's the name of my show. So, but what's cool is this is going to give you a running search from yesterday and today, 7 days out, 30 days out. So you can start to see all the different search queries here. Then you can come here to last 100 searches. Oh my goodness, you guys, all for free. It's gonna lay this out. You can download a CSV file to allow you to just do a little bit more comparison inside of your marketing. Really, really important though that you catch any of these ones who have zero search results. So let's go here and just randomly do a search for taco and see if that happens to pull up anything in our website. Who knows? No results found. Womp womp. Let's do a search, a refresh here and see it. It tracked it. It said taco was searched once and zero sad day results. Oh my goodness, you guys, this is a really cool plugin for you to be running. Super important. So what if you don't already have some sort of a search field? You know that you can go over into your appearance and go to widgets, and by default, there's a search option that you can drag and drop and put into your sidebar or into your footer. This is it right here. Just open that up and you can choose what available widgets will be relevant for your theme, right? You might have different options here based on your theme, but there's the ability to put that search feature inside anywhere in a widgetized space on your WordPress website, and it will start collecting this content for you, letting you know what your viewers are searching for. Really cool plugin, right? If you have questions, be sure to contact their support line. Connect with them directly. There might be some Q&A here that'll help you troubleshoot, but I didn't have any issues with it. I was really loving the experience. I hope you did too, and I hope to see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.